Informed consent is an issue I've worked with my friends and colleagues, Representative Elizabeth Fiedler and Senators Maria Colette and Katie Muth, since 2019. For 4 years, we've urged our colleagues to bring this important bill to a vote, to strengthen the trust that Pennsylvanians have in medical professionals, to protect bodily autonomy, and to highlight the importance of consent. It is my honor to stand here with you today as we finally see this bill get signed by the governor into law. While hospitals in and around Montgomery County have already abolished the practice of performing invasive medical procedures on unconscious patients without prior consent, other parts of the Commonwealth continued this approach to training. Such exams were labeled learning opportunities for students. However, unconscious, non-consenting women are no one's learning opportunity. If a coherent person declined a pelvic, prostate, or rectal exam, one would not be performed. Their response would not be open to interpretation, and people under anesthesia deserve the exact same respect. Patients' humanity is not tied to their consciousness. An unconscious person should never be viewed as merely an object for learning. Now, under Pennsylvania law, patients have the right to choose or refuse consent for such examinations to be performed for non-emergent teaching purposes. While this legislation affects all patients, it will have the greatest impact on women. When Senators Colette and Muth and Representative Fiedler and I were elected in 2019, Pennsylvania had recently been ranked 49th in the country for women in government. We and subsequent classes of elected officials have worked hard along with our colleagues to create and support impactful legislation that empowers women of all ages in the Commonwealth. From ending period poverty to combating black maternal mortality, improving access to and affordability of childcare and early childhood education to menopause education, dignity for incarcerated women, improving workplace safety, and preserving access to reproductive health care, we are here working together to create a better, safer Commonwealth.